Hans and Luck, retold and illustrated by Eric Carle. Hans had worked 7 years with the miller, and he felt it was time to go home. 7 years have passed, and that is too long, he said to his master one morning. I would like to see my mother. Please give me my wages, and I'll be on my way. Hans, said the miller, you have been a good and faithful worker. My wife and I shall miss you, but we wish you the best of luck and a safe trip home. The miller went to his strongbox and took out Hans' wages. Here is your pay, he said, and he gave Hans a piece of gold the size of his head. Hans wrapped the gold inside a sack and threw it over his shoulder. He took his walking stick in his hand, crossed the bridge to the road, and started on his way home. The road was rough and hilly, and the mid-morning sun was hot. Hans began to sweat. The gold seemed very heavy indeed. Just then, a horseman came galloping by.
Ah, said Hans, a horse is a fine thing. A horseman does not have to carry a heavy load like mine on his back.
What's in your sack? Asks the horseman.
It is a piece of gold, and it is quite a lump to carry, said Hans.
If you like, we will trade, said the horseman. I will give you the horse, and you will give me the gold.
A good deal, said Hans. The man helped Hans onto the horse, and then made off with the gold as fast as he could. Hans went on his way, feeling lucky to be riding along so easily. But the horse soon understood that Hans was no rider, and Hans was thrown onto the ground. A farmer milking his cow in a nearby field spotted the horse and helped Hans to his feet.
Hans was very thirsty. Dear man, he said to the farmer, it must be wonderful to have milk whenever you want some, and good fresh butter and cheese. Besides, how I would like to have a cow.
A cow is indeed a very fine thing, replied the farmer, but a horse can be useful too.
If you like, I will trade you my cow for your horse.
A good deal, said Hans. A horse is not for me. I will never ride that animal again. A cow will suit me better.
He took the cow, and the farmer climbed onto the horse and rode away in a great hurry. Hans felt he was the luckiest man in the world, and he sat down to milk his cow. But milking a cow was something he had never done before, and he was clumsy at it. He pushed and pinched and pulled, but the cow would give no milk. Hans tried again, twice as hard. At last the cow became impatient. She raised one of her hind legs and gave Hans a good kick. Just then it happened that a man was passing by on the road. He had a big fat pig, which he was taking to market.
Why should the cow kick you? Asked the man.
Hans told of his troubles. The cow looks poorly, said the man. Maybe she doesn't give much milk.
What? Said Hans. How much better if I had a lovely fat pig like yours. Pork chops and roast, to say nothing of sausages.
Well, said the man, just for you, I'll trade. You take the pig, and I'll take the cow. The exchange was made, and Hans set out again. But the pig was stubborn. No matter how much Hans wanted to go one way, the pig wanted to go the other way. Besides, it squealed and screeched and grunted like, well, just like a pig. Hans was getting discouraged when a woman with a fat goose walked by.
Eggs for breakfast, Hans thought, and feathers for a pillow, and a roast for Christmas, all from one bird? Perhaps the woman is willing to trade.
The woman knew a good bargain when she saw one and was happy to trade. Hans went on and was close to home when he saw a knife grinder at work. What fun! Sparks were flying through the air, and the grinder's money pouch was full of coins.
That's a fine goose you have, said the grinder. Where did you buy it?
It was a lucky swap, said Hans, and he told the grinder of all his trades, starting with the lump of gold.
You have a good head for business, said the grinder. You should take up my work.
How can I do that? Said Hans. I have no grindstone.
Well, said the grinder, as he picked up a loose cobblestone from the road, it so happens that I have an extra one. I'll trade it just for the goose. And so they traded a goose for the old cobblestone. Hans felt he was the luckiest man in the world, but he had walked a long way and he was very tired and thirsty. The stone grew heavier and heavier every minute. At last he came to a water fountain. He put the stone at the fountain's edge and bent over to take a drink. The stone rolled over and sank deep into the water with a loud plump. Hans laughed. How lucky am I, he said. Now I am free with nothing to carry anymore. And he ran home where his mother saw him coming and rushed to greet him. Oh, Hans, how I have missed you, said his mother. How wonderful it is to have you home again. She gave him a big warm hug and led him to the most comfortable chair in the house so that he could sit and rest. Then she bustled around, telling him all the village news while she prepared his favorite supper, a dish of steaming dumplings. Now, more than ever, Hans felt that he was the luckiest man in the world.